Hey guys, how to open and run your first successful restaurant. Why are chefs so grumpy? Why a lot of them, when you see chefs, they end up being pretty chubby? Yes, because they are tasting all the food they are having. But you know, I think a lot to do has to do with stress. You know, there is so many different variables in the restaurant business. I mean, so many things can definitely go wrong. The ingredients, the cooking, temperature, the guests not showing up, the guests showing, more people showing than expected, the waiter not showing up, the waiter, making a mistake. There is so many different things that can go wrong. You know, overcooking, undercooking, missing an ingredient. You know, there are recipes, and recipes involve time. There is a cooking time. So if you mess it up sometimes by minutes, you know what? It can literally ruin the taste of the dish. So the chef slash restaurant owner and overall the chefs are always knowing that, hey, something is not as great as it should be. So they always end up being perfectionists, you know, they seek perfection. But in a world that is not perfect, this will lead to stress. So you find a lot of them grumping, screaming around, and things of the kind, and that in the long run will affect their health. And I met many professionals in the restaurant industry, and most of the time when they end up being past their 5 or 10 years of working in the business, they get to a point that, like, you know, if there was something that you will do differently, you'll be like, Sham, listen, I would not have stressed as much, you know, instead of trying to make things super complex and fancy and perfect and relying on the human factor. You know, I did create myself a lot of turmoil, lots of stress. So if it was to be redone again, I will do something a little bit simpler, focus on simpler recipes, consistent and repeatable processes, just for my sanity, you know. And when something tastes good, it does taste good. So please, when you see a chef, know that in their world, they're just thinking about all the different things can go wrong. And when you're a professional or when you're an owner, this is something that you take with you home. You're always thinking about it, you know, and take it easy, you know. So at the same time, if you are not a chef, now you understand a little bit the world where the chef is living in. Not only he has to focus on the kitchen, make sure that everything is good, but then it's his reputation on the line. Also, one thing to know is that there is a kind of a difference. I know it's changing in the industry thanks to lots of hospitality schools that are trying to do the best they can. But you know, most of the time, we assume that people from the back of the house are not as well-educated and well-spoken as the people on the front of the house. You know, the front of the house people most of the time are like the pretty faces and the good talk and the schmoozing of the guests versus the nitty-gritty, the hardcore dealing with fire and knives at the back of the house. So because of that, you will find in lots of restaurants that there is lots of cussing around in the kitchen. And as a restaurant owner or a chef, you want to have this kind of good energy inside your kitchen, because I do personally believe, I have no way to prove it, but you know, this energy will get inside your food. Think about a home-cooked meal. Sorry, my coffee was about to spill there. Think about a home-cooked meal and the love that's made into it. So when you have new hire, this is also a very good thing to say, you know what, we have a no cussing policy. If the chef is cussing, well, guess what, it's going to open doors for everybody else to cuss and thus increase their stress. So always positive energy out there. And now, my friend, you do know why the chefs can be have kind of schizophrenic personalities. Sorry for all the chefs out there, but they're always thinking about what's going wrong, and every time something does go wrong, it's never as perfect as they want. And when you keep on doing that for 3 years back to back 24/7, well, guess what, it does affect your personality and you become kind of a little bit of a grumpy person. So I want the chefs to be happy, I want them to be pleased. So everybody who is not a chef, please take into consideration that, you know, try to create a positive environment for the chef and know when to talk to them. You know, they're dealing with fire, their knives, and suddenly somebody comes in and assume that the world is going to stop because the chef, well, said that he has an open door policy. Do respect their time and their blood pressure. So that was how to open and run your first successful restaurant. Be kind to all the chefs out there. Chef, keep up the good work. Thanks for being patient with us. And until our next video.